Now, we've talked about acts of nature. We've talked about fires. We've talked about theft. One thing we haven't talked about is something that could very well be our fault. Dad, I know you just bought me a new tablet. I lost it. I don't really remember where I left it, but I don't have it, or I lost my cell phone. Cell phones today, some of them cost $400 or $500. That's a hell of a loss. Can I insure these things?
You sure can. You know, I hear all the time, Dad, I dropped my phone in the toilet. Uh-oh. Now what do? That phone's toast. You know, some of the kids have come up with this rice therapy for their cell phones. They drop it in the water, they dry it off, they take out the battery, they lay it out in the sun for 5 minutes and then put it in rice in a baggie and try and restore it. Not going to work, kids. That insurance to if you lose or drop or what have you with your cell phones, that insurance on the phone is also relatively inexpensive in relation to the cost of a new iPhone 6 now, you know, probably going to be $700. That insurance is cheap. It covers the phone. And, you know, if you haven't lost one or destroyed one or forgot one, I did a couple weeks ago on a flight to Dallas out of Los Angeles. And next thing I knew, I didn't have a phone. I thought, oh, no problem. I'll call the airline and it'll be sitting there right in my seat. No, it wasn't, and I know right where I left it, right in my seat. So that insurance is smart coverage, especially if you've got a laptop where you can just walk in to the Apple store or to wherever you're going, HP, and replace it. I'm a fan.
Yeah, and here is the deal. If you have insurance on not the latest model, but a former model of whatever phone it is that you possess. It's been my life's experience, Frank, that you're going to get a replacement, but it ain't always going to be that. I'm sorry, Mr. Darris, but that model has been discontinued, or it's hard to get, or we can't get it, or frankly, we're just going to try to sell you and update you and bamboozle you into the latest. It's going to cost you a few extra $100 that we're going to put in our pocket, even though your cell phone was insured.
Yeah, that's why the upgrade coverage, if you've got renter's insurance and you know, the insurance that you can buy that, I know how it is. You're at the checkout line at Best Buy or wherever you're going to get your electronics, and the last thing that they're going to do is hit you for $139, and it's a quick sell with 10 people behind you, and most people just say no. Hey, that is decent insurance, and, you know, would you rather admit you lost it and it was a $2,000 item that you can just go down and get the latest and the greatest new model to replace it? Or do you want brain damage and have to fight with the carrier about whether it's this model or that model and the depreciation should be $46 as opposed to $146? Thanks, no. I want to write my check for my premium, and I want to know if it gets lost, stolen, somehow damaged, that I can just walk in there and replace it. Had that experience too, Gary. Went down to the place that I bought some electronics, a little 35-inch television, was going to mount it in my kid's room at college, laid it down on the bed, didn't realize that his roommate had placed a screwdriver on top of the bed. I laid down the TV, had no idea, didn't hear a crack or anything. Then got up to mount the TV. Sure enough, TV destroyed. I hadn't left the electronics store 45 minutes earlier, and there I was back at the store, and the manager said, man, wasn't that the best $100 that you spent on that TV? You used it within an hour of when you bought it.